It's interesting to speculate on how quickly the whole cult, if you like, of Hammer horror took hold. The Curse of Frankenstein came out in 1957, and I think by the late 1960s, Hammer horror was very much already a brand. It already meant something to the general public. It was part of that process whereby nowadays Hammer and horror are almost synonymous in the public mind.
I always thought that a Dracula should not be a Nosferatu. He was too ugly. I always thought a Dracula should be immensely handsome and beguiling to women.
You want to be careful what you're saying.
People have said they thought it looked quite sort of a bit sexy, you know, which is obviously, I mean, Dracula is, you know, he's the ultimate.
You know, Hammer's often accused of not moving with the times, but what they're doing with that film and several films of that era is backing new talent, trying to find a future generation.
I summoned you!
It was my will.
Plus, they could get tremendous booking because they were Warner Brothers. And so these movies got in front of a lot of eyeballs that they never had previously gotten in front of.
These were films which were very much directed towards this countercultural audience at the time and ramped up the sex and violence.
Ready when you are, gentlemen.
Film was something which I think is to get into it, younger you are, the more adventurous you are. You can do things, you can make mistakes, but you actually do things which probably an older person wouldn't dare to do.
What was going wrong was not their attempt to modernise. What was going wrong was the absence of production money.
Vampire film was an unhappy film, in actual fact, for a lot of people.
It was the inevitable end of the affair.
Permanent CEO
yes.
Director.
Yes, absolutely.
I'm not going to enjoy this, no, and who dares?